Hey guys, it's me, Stormy, and here is your weekly horoscope for the week of January 27th. Before we jump in, this is the last week of enrollment for Astrology 101 and 102. We will be studying together live on Sundays for about 12 weeks, just learning astrology from the ground up, putting it all together so that you just get to start speaking this wonderful language of astrology. So if you'd like to join, please click in the description box down below. Get signed up before that window closes, okay? All right, this week is kind of a dreamy week. We actually jump into this week with some energy that I love, but I'm also kind of cautious about. And that is having Venus, who has now come into the energy of Pisces, so kind of bringing a very forgiving, artistic vibe to what we've got going on. But Venus is going to actually come into conjunction right here on the 27th, right at the beginning of the week, with Neptune, who's also in Pisces. And Neptune is over there completely comfortable. He's in rulership, domicile, so working magically over there in that Pisces energy. But as Venus and Neptune come together, first of all, I love them together because I call them the Bopsy twins, right? They get together and things are so good. They're so blissful. There's love. There's compassion. There's certainly an opportunity for romance to blow in, or a delicious financial something. But the challenge with this energy and why I put it in the forecast as a day that's a little bit more foggy and we probably need to not make huge business decisions, huge life decisions, is because when Venus and Neptune travel together, they just make everything too good, right? It's very much so that rose-colored glasses kind of situation. So let's say the X rolls back in and you're like, they're completely changed. If it's been 2 weeks, they're not changed, okay? So think about what's happening. This is a day to pause. You could be seeing something that is not actually all of the facts. So I will tell you, it's a pause day for me, but you do you, okay? Now, the other things that I think about is, first of all, if you happen to have Venus conjunct Neptune in your natal chart, one of the things that this helps you to be is very artsy. And your art may not be that you make music or do poems. You could be artsy in just some way. There's a very in-between the worlds place about you. It's a very romantic, idealistic energy. So maybe the way that you come at things is very, it's very rom-com. You know what I mean? Like, it's a romantic comedy. You're going to give love and you expect other people to give love. And it's just all love. So that could be a quality that you very much so have experienced within yourself as you bring it to the table. But as we continue to work with it in transit, since the transiting energies bring in energies to our charts, some of the things we want to be mindful of are, yes, compassion, new romance, the music, the creative, all of that good stuff. But I don't want you to get lost in this energy this week. Don't get lost in the sauce. Don't get too lazy with this energy because it can also make you very, very chilled out, okay? Now, on the 28th, to kind of help navigate any decisions you maybe were thinking about making, we've got Mars coming into a square with Neptune, and there is nothing like a square to wake up what's really going on, right? But again, I put the 28th in kind of a foggy day as well because maybe we are just not clear on all of the facts. So when Mars comes into a square with Neptune, first of all, that square stimulates us to stop and think. We're under tension. We've got to make some decisions and take some actions. So Mars, our planet of action and energy and movement, right? He's going to run in and he's going to square Neptune and say, hold on a minute. What are you doing? What have we got going on? One of the other things I think that Venus-Neptune energy could bring to the table is maybe if you're addressing something that you feel guilty about, right? Or something you feel ashamed of. Mars may be coming in here squaring that energy going, hold on, that's not going to work for us. We need to come at this from a different way. We need a different attitude. We need different actions around this, right? But Mars in a square to Neptune is like running in water, right? So you can feel like your energy is a little bit low. You want to combat these things, but Mars is just saying, stop, I need you to get all of the facts, right? I need you to explore. Let's investigate what's here before we take actions that are going to leave us susceptible to something that we don't really want to experience. In scenarios with other people, in relationships, just because this is a Venetian energy that's also in here, there could be this tendency to be a little bit jealous or a little bit overpossessive, or you're wondering why you feel like you're struggling in your relationships this week, or like, why do I just feel so unsettled? And what I would tell you is don't let your imagination get the best of you this week, guys. Take positive actions, right? Take positive actions that are backed by facts that allow you to know that you're taking the best possible action that you can. If you need to take any actions at all, you might be able to survive being on pause for just a couple days and experiencing the information that's coming up for you. Now, as we end this week and we move into the beginning of February, we actually see the sun in a square to the moon. So we've got the sun over here in Aquarius and the moon is over here at this time in the energy of Taurus. So these two are going to come into a square with each other. The sun is very much so an external kind of energy. The moon is an internal emotional kind of energy. So when these two square each other, again, the square is saying, ha, we got to change something here. We need to take action. We need to do something different here, right? So as the sun comes into a square between these two, areas that have to do with your vitality outside of your home versus things happening inside of your home, maybe there's something that is not in balance in one of these areas, right? Your needs versus your wants. And even though I know that sounds like an opposition, if one of these areas is out of balance, that square is going to stimulate you to change something. A square says, I'm going to put you under some challenge, maybe because this is a sun moon. Maybe it's I'm putting you under some emotional pressure to make some changes, or maybe your external environment is putting you under some kind of pressure and it's making you feel some kind of way emotionally at home. The other thing about the moon taking on the sun is that because the moon is so subconscious and can very much so be an unconscious energy sometimes, if something's been negative, or it's like princess in the pea, if you've had something little kind of disturbing you down there under your 75 mattresses, the sun may push it out and say, hey, address that. We need to move on, right? Or it might say, hey, let's take an adjustment to this. And sometimes what happens for me, and people tell me about it all the time when it happens, is that people around me can pick up on me being tense in some way more quickly than I can. And then it gets to just be my indicator that I'm like, yeah, what's bugging me? What's getting at me? Or, hey, that's even kind of exciting. Why am I still sitting still? I need to go ahead and take some action. So depending on how this shows up for you, because it can be a sub or unconscious kind of energy, you may not be aware of it. And this square may stimulate you to see that something's going on, or that you have an idea down there you just haven't been able to act on because everything's been so foggy in the beginning of the week, right? So it is a week of delicious still. There is a lot of creativity available this week. There is a lot of abundance available this week. Just make sure the actions you're taking are facts, and also allow the universe to show you, right? We had this lunar eclipse in Cancer. Maybe it's trying to show you something about your security. We had a new moon that was happening in Aquarius, and that's about independence and freedom. So, you know, maybe there's something about, do you want to be more independent over here versus how you make security out of that? Whatever's coming up for you this week, please share it with me, because I would love to support you in whatever changes you're trying to make and in whatever directions you're trying to travel. All right, you guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I love you, and I will see you guys next week. Bye.